So let us march forth this evening with renewed vigor and with strengthened resolve. Let us march forth with remembrance of better days gone by and candles held in our hands to illuminate the path to a brighter future.
This is what democracy looks like!
Goes after all y'all that's commissioned us for mad years. One love, yo. That's right, he's got game. PE 1998.
Man is the father, the son is the
sister. Hey, I like the platforms, whatever. Here's $1 million. Go wreak some havoc. Once you get elected, remember to put you like this. You're going to owe me some favor. And if you fail, uphold your end of the bargain, satiating my desire for whatever I want. Next time around, I'll give $1.5 million to your opponent because they might actually listen. 93% of funds donated to political action committees come from a mere 750 individuals. That's less than one-fifth of the population of this group. Think about it, 750 individuals commanding 93% of campaign expenditures in a country of 300 million people. The democracy that we cherish so highly is quick to be turning into a plutocracy. The transition from rule by the people to rule by the rich is underway at this very moment as I stand here before you. And things are really only looking worse in the foreseeable future, but that is exactly why we're out here this evening. We're out here to make a statement. We're out here to exercise our First Amendment rights. We don't have the money to buy political favors or attention. All we have is our voices, our hearts, and our minds. All we can give is our time and our physical presence, and though the Supreme Court may not recognize your presence here tonight as a legitimate form of speech, I assure you that your presence speaks volumes. We are here this evening to help cast off the veil of ignorance and misinformation that has blanketed our people for too long. We are here this evening to remember. We are here to remember that things have not always been this way. We're here to remind people that things were once better than this, that they can be once again. We are here to illuminate the dark recesses of the collective consciousness of this nation and bring into the light the true embodiment of government of the people, for the people, by the people. Just as the flame starts with a single candle, so does the movement for truly free and fair elections start with a single audience. And I assure you, and it will spread from person to person, just as the flickering light of four candles will ignite the candles of the neighbors standing next to you. It will spread from household to household, from city to city, from state to state. No longer shall we fear offending our oppressor, for they have their heels on our necks. And if we don't act now, we will no longer have the breath to continue politely asking them to relinquish their grip. We the people must rise up and educate ourselves, our friends and neighbors. My friends, the time for action is now, and the place for action is before you. This night, we demonstrate to ourselves, to our community, and to those who would seek to oppress us, that we, the American people, have awakened from our slumber. We will not be silenced, and we will not submit to corporate servitude. I tell you that the community of people here today has the ability to move mountains. I tell you that actions speak far louder than words, that actions even speak far louder than money. I tell you that actions will be the thing to overcome the cacophony of cash that has muted the voice of the people for far too long. So let us march forth this evening with renewed vigor and with strengthened resolve. Let us march forth with remembrance of better days gone by and candles held in our hands to illuminate the path to a brighter future. Thank you.
Question is, are you ready for the real revolution, which is the evolution of the mind? If you seek, then you shall find that we all come from the divine. You dig what I'm saying? Now if you take heed to the words of wisdom that are written on the walls of life, then universally we will stand, and divided we will fall,